We begin with rising tensions in the South Jersey community after a man's racist rant is captured on video. Good evening, everyone. I'm Yuki Washington.
And I'm Jessica Cartaglia. Dozens of protesters gathered outside the man's home in Mount Laurel after a video of the confrontation with his neighbor went viral. Late this evening, police took the man into custody. Alexandria Hoff is in Mount Laurel, where the protests got a little heated. Alex.
Well, that's right, Yuki. Jessica, protesters were out here because they were upset that this man, seen in videos using racial slurs, was charged with harassment but then allowed to return home. Well, new charges did emerge this evening, and he was taken into custody in dramatic fashion. It was a dramatic home removal for a man who many claim had been harassing neighbors outside of his Mount Laurel home for years. Police were called to the 3600 block of Gramercy Way Friday shortly after a disturbing video went viral where police say 45-year-old Edward Cagney Matthews was shouting offensive and racial slurs at a neighbor.
This monkey over here, this monkey over here.
On Friday, Matthews was charged with biased intimidation and harassment.
The judge decided that they should be on a summons. So that evening, Mr. Matthews was released.
Monday afternoon, protesters arrived to his home demanding police take Matthews into custody.
This is America. We all live here. We can't put up with this.
Several years ago, Aaliyah Robinson's daughter, Jasmine, lived below Matthews in a different nearby apartment complex.
I'm literally in fear all the time living with my son. Like, what am I supposed to do?
Once the recent video was shared online, Jasmine decided to upload one that she had taken years back where a man she describes as Matthews repeatedly used
And now here I go looking like a f***er. You're calling the cops.
I totally understand why the protesters were here today. They had seen videos that weren't available to us on Friday night that were even worse.
Once that new video was reviewed, new charges were added, including assault. The decision was made to arrest Matthews. The protests that had remained calm all day got heated as police and SWAT units pulled Matthews from his home. Several bottles were thrown at Matthews' home and at police, but many community members urged that action to stop.
Police are still on scene where, excuse me, there was actually mace tossed into the crowd tonight by a member of the crowd, I'm told, and I'm kind of dealing with the aftermath of that. But police still are on scene. We're told that two arrests were made. Now, those in the neighborhood told me at least 10 people were victimized, and it went beyond just verbal harassment, but physical as well. Reporting live in Mount Laurel, Alexandria Hoff, CBS 3 Eyewitness News.
Alex, thank you.